Channel 4 reporter Amy Cho interviewing Fort Meade Garrison Commander Colonel Tom Rickard yesterday at the Freedom Inn's annual Thanksgiving Day feast. I'll post a link to her report with this newscast. Hello and welcome to a day after Thanksgiving edition of Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also this week, USO hands out 800 turkeys. We visit Maryland Therapeutic Writing with EFMP. Fort Meade's 100th anniversary in book form. These stories and more, but first, 6 years ago, a group of business, government, and community leaders formed the Fort Meade Community Covenant Council. The council addresses the needs, issues, and concerns of service members, veterans, civilians, and their families in the Fort Meade region. Periodically, the council meets to reaffirm their pledge to the Fort Meade community.
What we're doing here, what we've done twice before, is really formalizing a set of relationships that would exist with or without this particular piece of paper and without the signatures. But I think we do the signing, we do formalize it because it means so much to us. And we want to kind of broadcast that to the broader world and say we stand by this partnership because it's that important.
Elsewhere, Walmart stores in Laurel, Arbutus, and Severn got together last week and donated more than 800 turkeys to active duty service members here on Fort Meade. All 800 turkeys were given away, and vouchers were given to those who were still waiting in line. Walmart market manager Debbie Ziskowski says there was a local connection to the giveaway.
One of our store managers, his name is Tony from our Laurel, Maryland store, is extremely connected to the communities and actually has one of his assistant managers, significant others, is actually stationed on this base here. And we really wanted to do an outreach to the USO, you know, on behalf of what they're doing for us and for, you know, serving our country. So we thought it'd be a wonderful initiative to donate turkeys to the USO. So we gathered a few stores so it could be a united community effort, and here we are.
In other news, Maryland Therapeutic Riding, located just minutes from Fort Meade in Crownsville, Maryland, offers a variety of horseback riding programs for children and adults dealing with a wide range of physical, mental, and emotional challenges. Maryland Therapeutic Riding has become a regular part of Fort Meade's Exceptional Family Member Program, or EFMP.
This Maryland Therapeutic Farm, they allow 20 of our special needs family members come out here and enjoy it. They do everything from grooming to actually horseback riding on this beautiful farm. And again, it is very therapeutic. We also have some wounded warriors that come out here and do this.
Service members enroll in the EFMP when they have a family member with a physical, emotional, developmental, or intellectual disorder. The EFMP works with military and civilian agencies to provide coordinated services to families with special needs. Part of the program is regular recreational outings.
Get them involved, a lot of networking opportunities to meet other families, and sometimes we cater our recreational events just for this, you know, these family members.
The therapeutic riding has been a hit with program members. Unmi Song, an EFMP parent, likes the therapy aspect, but really likes the fact that kids learn a lot.
I think I like it. I mean, it's just they have opportunity for us riding the horse, and they know how to grooming the horse and, you know, what they're supposed to eat and, you know, what they're supposed to, you know, feeding and comfort and everything. So I like it.
If you want to learn more about EFMP, stop by their offices at Army Community Services.
We learn so much from our family members, from our parents who actually navigate in the system. I mean, they come in and they share information with us. So I would just encourage anyone, just if they don't even want, you know, maybe not meet other people, if they just come into the office, we have resource libraries. Let us take some of that burden off of you let us navigate through the system for you.
As you no doubt know, Fort Meade has been celebrating its 100th anniversary all year. Last week, the culmination of a community-wide effort spearheaded by our own public affairs Mary Doyle and Sherry Kuiper came to fruition. Fort Meade, the first 100 years, is an expansive visual and written look at Fort Meade's first 100 years. At a recent authors panel held at the Severn Library, Doyle says that dozens of people were recruited to contribute.
We talked about kind of what types of essays we wanted, and she already knew people who were experts in the Hello Girls and people who are experts in tank things, and, you know, so we called on these other experts, and the essays started coming in, and that's really when we started kind of getting a real feel of what this thing was going to end up being.
The electronic version is now online. There are multiple links to it on the Fort Meade homepage. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.